Some of Asia's most powerful leaders are right now meeting in Melbourne, trying to maintain peace in the waters to our north. As part of the ASEAN summit, the Albanese government tonight unveiling a multi-billion dollar program to encourage more investment in Asia and bring more jobs to Australia.
Leaders of the region's middle powers joining hands in a unified, if ungainly, show of solidarity. 9,000 kilometres away, a show of force. In Beijing's Great Hall of the People, a great display in honour of just one person. Let us unite more closely around the Central Committee, Chairman Wang said, with comrade Xi Jinping at its core. Different summits with different approaches, but both in a race for growth in our region.
Now we can speak about the proximity of opportunity, located where we are.
Tonight, the Australian government pledging $2 billion, underwriting and incentivising Australian investment throughout Asia, with a focus on business and clean energy. The ASEAN bloc, now Australia's second largest trading partner, surpassing the United States.
It's more jobs, it's more opportunity, and it's more growth.
Middle powers working together to stake our claim as the big beneficiaries of the change which is happening all around us.
Back-to-back meetings of face-to-face leaders with the promise of standing side by side.
At these summits, leaders expect to talk tax and trade, but tonight there's a surprise topic. Taylor Swift.
Singapore singled out by other leaders for signing the pop star to an exclusive Asian stop on her Eras tour.
I don't see that as being unfriendly. Sometimes one country makes a deal, sometimes another country does.
Making him tonight Asia's and Charles Cratcher, Nine News.